In my medical alert tonight, new research shows that more children are getting a handle on their cholesterol levels. A government study done over the last two decades focused on more than 16,000 people ages 6 to 19, and results show a slight improvement in total cholesterol levels. There was also a drop in the number of kids with high cholesterol from 11% to 8%. There is a new study out tonight, and the results may surprise you. It has to do with obese people who have type 2 diabetes. A report published in the Journal of American Medical Association finds that overweight people live longer than people with a healthy body weight at the time that their disease is detected. Researchers say this is due to a higher body mass index. Doctors say people who have normal BMIs are twice as likely to die. Despite this, doctors are encouraging obese people not to abandon their weight loss efforts. A warning tonight for anyone with kids who ride in cars. New information says that not enough is being done to keep them safe while on the road. Here's Dr. Timothy Johnson.
Automobile crashes are the number one killer of children between the ages of 1 to 12 in the U.S. All 50 states have laws requiring some form of child safety seats for autos. But a study in the American Journal of Preventive Medicine finds increased danger for young passengers because they are not properly secured. The most common safety lapses: children are not kept in rear-facing seats after age 1, fewer than 2% of children remain in a booster seat after age 7, and many children over age 6 are allowed to ride in the front seat. The American Academy of Pediatrics calls for children to be in rear-facing seats until at least age 2, then forward-facing car seats with a 5-point harness for as long as possible, booster seats until the child is over 57 inches tall, and riding in the back seat until age 13. With this Medical Minute, I'm Dr. Timothy Johnson.